Hello friends, welcome to my channel tutelf.com. Today the topic we are discussing is scalar and vector. So scalar and vector, it is two type of physical quantities. Now let's see what they are basically. So you can see this car on the screen. So if I say that you have to cover 2 kilometer distance, so now the car can go in any direction. It can go in front, it can go in this north east direction, in the north direction, in the northwest direction, in the west direction, anywhere it wants to go, irrespective, because we didn't mention the direction in which it has to go. Now if I say that you have to travel 2 kilometer in the east direction, so we would know that we have to go, let me change the pen so that you get the idea. So I will know that I have to go 2 kilometer east in this direction. So basically the two things which were said just now by me were 2 kilometer and west. Now when I just say 2 kilometer, that means that I'm mentioning the one dimensional perspective of it. So one dimensional, it gives us a scalar quantity, and if I have the direction associated with it, then it becomes a two dimensional, and in that case we have a vector quantity. I hope this part is clear to you. So when I'm just mentioning the distance, then it is 2 kilometer and it is a scalar quantity. And when I give the direction along with the distance, then it becomes the displacement and I get a vector quantity. So now for the scalar quantities, we have few things like speed. Speed is a scalar quantity because we do not mention the direction along with that. But velocity, on the other hand, would be a vector quantity. The unit, and let's see one more example. So we have concluded that scalar only has magnitude associated with it, and the vector quantities has both magnitude and direction associated with it. Scalar quantity is one directional and vector quantities is a two directional unit. Now if I say that the temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, so 30 degrees Celsius is the magnitude, and the magnitude, that means that this is a scalar quantity. Now if I say that there is a rise of 30 degrees Celsius in the thermometer, then it becomes a vector quantity, because I am telling the direction also. 30 degree rise or 30 degree falls gives us a vector quantity. Now let's do a quick revision. For example, if I need to say mass, the mass, it does not have a direction associated with it, so mass would be a scalar quantity. But if I say weight is mass times acceleration due to gravity, and we know that the acceleration due to gravity acts in the downward direction, so it becomes a vector quantity. Now other one, I'll take acceleration is a change in the velocity, so since velocity has direction associated with it, so acceleration would be a vector quantity. Let's do a quick revision and summarization of the concept we have just learned. So physical quantities of two types, scalar and vector. Scalar has only magnitude associated with it, such as 20 meter, and the vector has the both magnitude and direction associated with it. Speed, for example, is a scalar quantity, and weight, since it has mass and gravity, it is a product of mass and gravity, acceleration due to gravity, and acceleration due to gravity is the direction, it gives you the direction, downward direction, so it's a vector quantity. We will be learning about more about the scalar and the vector quantities as we proceed more in our chapters. And each and every time I mention a new quantity, I'll be telling you whether the quantity is a scalar quantity or a vector quantity. Till now, we have studied speed, which is a scalar quantity, velocity, which is a vector quantity, distance, which is a scalar quantity, and displacement, which is a vector quantity. Thank you for being part of tutelf.com. You can even visit our site www.tutelf.com. If you need any material related to first to 12th, you can just switch on to the site and have a look for science and maths. And you will find few question answers also there, which if you attempt, will be graded as soon as you attempt those. So thank you for being a part of it. Stay safe, stay connected. If you have not subscribed, please do subscribe and like the video. Thank you so much. Also, if you require anything, you can just comment. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Stay safe. Take care. Bye-bye.